we're going to continue to explore ways of gaining back market share for press through innovative thinking and strategic partnerships. Heading up the roundtable is Lisa Scott. She'll come on up here to introduce the rest. Many of you already know Lisa as the executive director of the PBAA, Periodic and Book Association of America. It's what she's been doing this entire millennium so far. And previous to that, she's always been a great leader in our business and actually was running companies in this business when many women were just barely getting a toehold. So let's welcome Lisa.
Thank you. I've always wondered why round tables are set up as rectangles. As Lisa said, the name of our presentation was Winning Back Market Share Through Bold Marketing, Strategic Partnerships, and Customer Insight. But the key word in all this was left out. It's retailers. And that's who's up here. I'm always happy to come to Canada for Business. Each August, we at PBAA have a day-long conference called PBAA Canada, which brings together publishers, retailers, wholesalers, distributors, and suppliers for meetings, presentations, and of course, food and drink and good fellowship. But in particular, I love exploring this country. I've canoed in the Canadian Arctic 30 years ago, motorboated across the waters of British Columbia, driven across the prairies and maritimes. I fell in love with Ottawa and Quebec City. And 2 weeks ago, I spent 10 days on a small ship which circumnavigated Newfoundland and visited Labrador. So I'm happy to serve, if asked, as an unofficial ambassador for this beautiful country and its friendly and diverse people. And for those Canadians in the audience, it's a fabulous place, and thanks for having us. I'd also like to thank David Owen for this opportunity to bring together these three successful retailers, and now friends, from the US, Canada, and Norway. They each represent the best in their respective markets, and they're optimistic, proactive, and moving press forward. My own association, PBAA, is committed to the vitality and viability of selling press at retail in the US and Canada. And of course, this is also the mission of DistroPress and of all of you at this Congress. I truly believe that this panel is the perfect closing segment to today's forums, since without our retail partners' passion and commitment to the press, the future indeed would be bleak, and we will provide the answers to Rich Allard's panel's desire for knowing about exceptionally productive promotions. Rebecca, Tommy, and Curtis will also show in quite different ways how their engagement with press and publishers has led to this creative merchandising and marketing in their shops, and given us all increased sales in a very challenging time for press. Thus, I'm honored to introduce my three panelists, and I'll do that now so that we can transition quickly between presentations. Rebecca Clark is the Senior Category Manager for Books and Magazines at Walmart Canada. Rebecca has led various strategic initiatives to increase the category sales, resulting in Walmart leading the number one share of magazines at retail in Canada. With her blend of personal and professional passion for magazines, she's a strong advocate with a fresh voice for the opportunity magazines have at retail in Canada. I've gotten to know Rebecca and Walmart Canada's successes over the past few years and consider her embracing of our category and enthusiasm in connecting press and Walmart's customers the great success story for our industry. Tommy Engvik is the marketing director at Interpress Norge, which is fully owned by the Rakuten Convenience Norway Narvesen. Tommy's responsible for sales, category development, and circulation. Tommy brought a group of 35 Narveston retailers and company managers to a forum organized by PBAA in New York in May, and I saw firsthand how committed to press the Narveston team is, and was particularly impressed by Tommy's creativity and talent in motivating retailers and developing strategies for increased press sales. Curtis Packer is the director of press promotion for OTG and has been in retail for 25 years. He's responsible for selling promotional space as well as integrating iPad technology into the offering. He's using that technology to help enhance the airport retail experience as well as to drive single copy sales. And I was fortunate a few months ago to spend several hours with Kurt at the Delta terminal at LaGuardia Airport in New York. And I've never seen such engaged and contented travelers waiting for flights. I do encourage those of you flying out of Pearson to try to see the OTG sites as well. Curtis's passion for our category is well known in the U.S. and Canada, and now he can share that with all of you. I've asked each of them to give a brief overview of their retail business as an intro to their presentation, and then discuss and show best practices and initiatives in trying to increase press sales. After the three presentations, we'll open it up for questions.